हेलो एवरीवन, गुड आफ्टरनून। माय नेम इज राहुल किरण असोले। आई एम फ्रॉम थर्ड ईयर बी फार्मेसी। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ एमिटी द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी एलुमनाई एसोसिएशन, आई वेलकम यू बैक टू दिस ब्रांड न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ जब वी मेट। इट इज इंडीड माय ग्रेट प्लेजर टू वेलकम अमंग अस द एलुमनाई ऑफ आवर इंस्टीट्यूशन। नॉट ओनली इज इट अ मोमेंट ऑफ हैप्पीनेस एंड नॉस्टैल्जिया फॉर अस, बट ऑल्सो एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन आवर अचीवमेंट्स एंड लर्निंग। Our alumni have established themselves as a successful individuals in almost every field of their lives, and we could not be any prouder of it. The talk show, Jab We Met, is very special for all of us because it gives us an opportunity to meet with our alumni after so long time, and also gives them an opportunity to tell us about their challenges, hurdles, and their achievements from various sectors of their lives which they have faced yet. It is a matter of great fortune for all of us, our alumni, Mr. Yogesh Mohite sir from 2010 B Pharmacy batch, have joined us in our today's episode of Jab We Met talk series. A very warm welcome to you, sir.
Thank you.
Talking further about Yogesh sir, Yogesh sir had completed his B Pharmacy in 2010. Sir had pursued his M.Pharm from Pharmaceutics Department from year 2012. Sir had many academic achievements, such as sir had qualified NIPER JEE in 2010 with All India rank 695. Sir had also qualified GPAT 2010 with All India rank 1044. Sir had also qualified ENAT 2010, which was organized by Manipal University, with All India rank 343. Sir had stood 62nd in Maharashtra in AUUC Associate CET in 2010. Sir had stood 7th in the University of Pune in Pharmaceutics Department in year 2012. Talking about Yogesh sir's working experience, sir is a quality assurance professional. Sir had worked as a senior officer at Intas Pharmaceutical Limited in Gujarat in quality assurance department. Sir had also worked as a assistant manager in Dr. Reddy's Laboratories Limited, Hyderabad, in a quality assurance department. Sir had also worked as a corporate quality assurance executive in McLeod's Pharma Limited in Mumbai. Sir currently is working now as a senior reviewer 1 in Apotex Pharma Limited in Mumbai. Now, I request you, sir, to give us a brief introduction about yourself, which I have missed in above points.
Yes. Thank you so much for the nice introduction. I think first of all, you know, I would like to thank all the alumni association and all the committee members to give me this opportunity. I think especially for the persons like me, I think I have visited only once since I have passed out from the college. So I think in only 2017 once I have visited the college only for a half an hour. That is also very less people I able to meet over there. So I think especially for persons like us who used to not visiting the college, it's a very good initiative. So continue this initiative and try to approach more and more people so that you will get more and more experiences from all of them. And regarding introduction, I think such a nice introduction, but I will again reintroduce myself. It's a part of this theme. So my name is Yogesh and I'm basically from Nasik. So I have completed obviously my graduation from MIT. Then I moved to Pune, where I pursued my master's from Sinagar College of Pharmacy. Then I moved to Ahmedabad and work in Intas Pharmaceutical Limited in quality management system. Then later on, I moved to Hyderabad in Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, where I have used working process validation related activities. Then I moved to Mumbai, Amchi Mumbai, you can say, and started working in corporate quality assurance in McLeod's Pharma. Then currently I'm associated with Apotex Pharma and taking care of the product quality review related activities. And my family is there in Nasik only, and I'm staying here with my wife. She is also a pharma professional and she is working in Cipla in corporate office. I think that's it.
Okay, sir. We are glad to have you, sir. And as you said, we are going to connect with all of our alumni and try to connect with them and take their achievements, their experiences for us. Those will be very helpful for us.
Yes,
so moving
sir,
forward,
we should be. Yeah.
Yes, sir. So moving forward, I would like to know you about you, sir, your opinion about the career in pharmacy and the post-graduation course after that.
As you all know that there is no end for the pharma profession, first of all. And second thing, I could say we should all be proud about the thing that we are part of such a noble profession, because you see, in this pandemic also, people are not looking after the other fields or other professions. They are having some hope from us only, like we will be having some research, we will do some magic and, you know, find out some vaccine for them. Yes. So it's a noble profession, okay? That is where we should be proud about it. Second thing, with respect to, you are asking about the vacancies or opportunities. So you just compare the number of opportunities we were having at the time of when we have passed out from the college and the current scenario. I think it's a drastic change. You can say in this 10 years or in this decade, most of the small companies have been, you know, started their businesses in maybe a primary packaging section or manufacturing of the API, manufacturing of the finished products. And also, if you see the existing companies which are already developed, like Mylan, Cipla, they have also expanded. They have started their establishing new units over throughout the India. And simultaneously, if you see the foreign investor, they are also like to, you know, invest in India, because we are having the skilled resources and all about that. So that is also a good thing, where there is opportunity to, you know, increase in a number of roles they are looking for. And also, if you see the other pharma competitors globally, so like China. So in China, they are not having that much good rapport with other world or other countries. So and they are also having few concerns with the GMP or, you know, delivering the good quality products. So ultimately, overall, it will be helpful for India only. And in upcoming years, definitely India will be come up with a very good, you know, giant pharma player in a globally. So there is no concern with respect to job opportunities. And third thing I would like to add over here is the job safety. Just imagine in this pandemic also, there are lots of, you know, fluctuation in a market. And obviously there are, you know, market recession. So most of the organization, they simply told, non-pharma organization, to be precise, they simply told employees to, you know, leave the jobs and all. But if comparatively, you will just imagine, in pharma, there is no such concern. Means throughout the life, you will never find yourself jobless. So I think that is why pharma profession is very good. So trust me, you have selected a very good profession. Just do it effectively.
Yes, sir.
Do reason, do it with rational, and definitely you will definitely come out with the flying colors. Yeah.
Yes, sir. In education system also, there is much more crowd which is coming towards the pharma field. Yes.
Correct, correct.
Absolutely. Exactly. Yes, sir. Okay. Sir, please tell us about your career objectives and your current job work.
Okay, so see, career objective, it's very clear. Like if you see my entire profile, it's been 8.5 years since I am in industries. And if you closely observe, in each of movement from one company to different company, other company, I have intentionally selected some another profile. Like in Intas, I used to do the quality management system related work. Then Dr. Reddy's, I intentionally selected process validation related activities. Later on, I moved to corporate quality assurance, where I used to take care of compliance part as well as, you know, self-inspection. And now I'm part of, again, a different function in the same quality, but in a different role, you can say product quality review. So my intention is that by the time I will be having 15 to 20 years of experience, at that time, I should have most you know, skills and knowledge of different fields. So that is one of my career objective, because, you know, the person who is having 80% knowledge of only one field will be never be a good asset for the company. You always try to be, you know, achieve more and more skills so that you will be a good asset for any organization. So that is only my objective. And with respect to your second question, like the activity which we are doing in Apotex. So see, it's an product quality review. So it's, you all know that in every regulatory body, they are, you know, asking for organization to do some product reviews, maybe annually. So there is a review period. Like, for example, from Jan 1st to 31st December, that this is one particular 1 year review period. So after a subsequent January, we will starting checking the all aspect of particular product throughout this year. Maybe the manufacturing changes which are implemented for that product, change in documentation, then how many batches have been manufactured? Is there any failure? Is there any investigation, critical points over there. Then again, we are assessing the trending also, like whatever the batch results for this particular year, whether they are robust enough or they are lying within the control limits which were already set based on the previous results. So based on like also we are assessing the market complaints for that particular product, then OS investigations, recall. So everything you can see A to Z of that particular product we are assessing throughout the year. It's a retrospective analysis, you can say. After completion, we are assessing in a retrospective way. So after that, we are based on the overall evaluation, we are just giving a product rating. So product rating, you may say it's our decision. So we are having authority to decide whether we can go with the continuation of the production, or we may stop the production, maybe due to some failures or issue, because ultimately we are dealing with the health or quality of the products. And also we can also suggest production and quality people, like you can have some scope for improvement in particular aspect of this product. So hold this product production and you work on few aspects and then you can continue the production. So it's our decision based on the overall data evaluation. So that is what we are doing over in Apotex. Yeah.
Okay, sir. So according to you, everyone must be all-rounder in every section.
Correct.
That and everyone must learn to.
Yes. Correct.
Yes, sir. So moving forward, sir, according to you, what would be the skills needed to be a top performer in this quality assurance section of the job?
Okay, you are asking me specifically for QA, but I will say it's overall. In any field, any organization, when entering into the company, there will be definitely a competition. And when you have to be, highlighted in amongst them, then you have to be something special or unique skills. So due to that, I think that whichever task will be assigned to you, you have to be contributed 100% in it. You have to be, justify fully whatever the skills you are having. If you are not having that much knowledge, you should be open enough to go and reach to the subject master expert who can, guide you to complete that task. And it's a continuous improvement phase where you can, gain the skills from others also. So I think that is the key skills required for any person and company also looking forward for these candidates. And yes, I think that is very important to contribute fully in any of the tasks. And with respect to only QA function, I will add that you all know that QA is nothing but a cross-check or verification. So we are not doing anything or we are not initiating anything. We are checking the whatever which is done by others. So we are having authority to, either deny their proposal or either improvise their proposal. So for that, you should have knowledge, basic fundamental knowledge. Then you should have the complete idea about the regulatory guidelines, whatever they're in a market, because we have to make a document in line with their requirements. So unless and until you are not having any basic knowledge or regulatory background, then you cannot decide or you cannot give the conclusive statement. So with respect to QA, I think we should be having very much reviewer quality, or you can say a cross verifier quality. And there should be lots of attention to the content, whatever proposed by someone. You have to be very, very, authenticate, and you should have some justification either to accept that proposal or reject that proposal. So I think that is the key skill specifically for the QA role. Yes.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Is there any additional courses or certification we can do before entering this QMS arena, like Six Sigma Yellow Green Belt?
Yes, very good question. I think this, because most of the time, these are the advanced techniques. You can say Six Sigma techniques. These are advanced statistical tools. But at this point of time, I'm not suggesting you to go through these advanced techniques, because your first motto should be to enter in an organization or to enter in a live stream. Then only you will gain some experience. Maybe by the time you will be having 5 to 10 years of experience, then maybe you can able to better correlate whatever you are doing and whatever is there in a Six Sigma technique. Because these techniques are mainly useful for the improvisation or maybe optimization, which is more relevant to research work. So unless and until you are not having any idea about the mainstream, you cannot correlate the thing. So better you go into the industry, then gain some knowledge, basic knowledge, and then you can go for such additional, courses or certification, anything you would like to do.
Yes, sir. Okay. Sir, any other online courses you want to suggest all the MPharm students?
Again, this is quite the same question. Again, I will say just try to enter into the organization, then maybe your area of interest will decide which course you should be taking. So maybe the few people are going into RA, so that simultaneously they can do the part-time regulatory affairs course from the any other, you know, entity or organization. Then many people are nowadays going for the intellectual property management, IPM, you can say. Many people are going for post-graduation diploma in management. There are lots of options, but I think right now my suggestion to all of you is just enter into mainstream and then decide, because after entering into industry, you are having lots of time, or you can say lots of time to go with the different suggestion. You can take review from your experienced people also, then you can decide which course will be more suitable for you. And it's definitely, it should be a value addition, not only to just avail a certificate from, you know, to attach in a resume and or portfolio. It is not the case. It should be a value addition, and it should be linked to whatever you are doing in an industry. That is only my suggestion to all of you.
Yes, sir. Okay. So moving forward, what challenges did you face as a beginner, and how did you deal with them?
Okay, this is also a great question. See, my basic education means school education is already completed in, I think, Marathi medium. So I think most of the people are having this problem, like they are very finding themselves inferior whenever there is an, multiple, groups, people who are very good in English or very good in communication.
Yes.
And that is obvious, because whenever there is an opportunity to, express yourself, you are finding yourself short of words, and due to that, maybe there is an inferiority complex. So that is also the case for me when I, because to, answer in a Viva or to write something in an exam paper, it's a difficult thing because it is a technical content, which is directly in a book. But whenever you are going in an industry and someone is asking about some content, so you are not able to express over there. So due to that, I think that was a main problem for me also in an initial stage. But thank God, in your first year itself, I have noticed that without this, I can't survive in an industry. And due to that, I have worked a lot on this particular, points. And I have still I'm working on it. But yes, I have almost resolved all the, those concerns which were faced during the beginning time or initial.
Yes, sir. Sir, I would like to add one sentence here. Sometimes the hurdles aren't really the hurdles at all for us. They are the welcome challenges for us, which test our patience.
Correct. You can take it as an opportunity. Whatever hurdles are there, it's nothing but an opportunity for you to explore, to work on it, and to come up as a good, player over there. Because it's your competition. It is not with the others. Because other people are always already learned that particular skill, and that's why they are in the industry. But if you are not, learning these skills on time, then definitely you will be getting yourself in a trouble.
Yes, sir, exactly. So moving forward, I would like to know how our college prepare you for your career.
Yes, definitely. Graduation is nothing but it's a foundation of, technical knowledge or technical base. So at that time, me, Nilesh Pandey is there. We were, first batch. So we come out as a first batch. So at that time, I think faculty members are also very young and dynamic. They are also that much experienced. But I think fantastic. They handle us very well. They taught us very good, they given very good lectures. They, guide us on time, like which courses we should be getting, which entrance exam we should be gone for or prepared for. Then after that, which colleges are good in the, market where we can go for the post-graduation. So teaching as well as guidance, I think both aspects they have covered very well. So I think, yes, definitely credit goes to all the faculty members and college as well. Yeah.
Yes, sir, exactly. Our college faculty, all of the faculty are all supportive, and they shows us the right pathway.
Correct.
According to the strength of the student, that where go and where should not go.
Yes, sir, I agree. Exactly. 100% agree. Because for you people, there are seniors. But for us, there were no any seniors at that time. So whatever the faculty members, they are only our seniors. So that's why.
Yes, sir. Sir, I would like to know, how was your first interview like? And can you please share your experiences from your first interview?
Yes, see, I think my first interview was held in Ahmedabad in Intas Pharma. At that time, I have not got my results also for masters. And I have selected for the interview. So I went to interview and there were two persons. One is quality head and second one, I think, general manager of quality assurance. So he started with the introduction, general introduction. So we have already prepared for it. There is no any concern. And the first question I think he asked to me is what is mean by deviation? So we all know that whatever we have learned from book, like I have freshly passed out. Okay. So whatever learned from book is standard deviation. So I have explained everything about standard deviation, whatever the formula, what is the rationale, what is the use. But if you see in the industry, deviation is having some different meaning. Like there are procedures which are already set for doing something, but if you, you know, divert that procedure, it will become a deviation.
Yes.
So he's expecting that from me, but as I am fresher, I have just explained him standard deviation, which is not wrong. Afterwards, I have also explained him that we are fresher, we are not knowing the terms which is applicable for the industry. You can ask anything about the research work or whatever we have done in academics. So later on, he asked me questions regarding my thesis. And as you all know, we are working for 1 year on that thesis. So we know
exactly
everything A to Z about the thesis. So we have explained very well. And due to that, I think I have got selected.
Yes. Many of us are very nervous for our first interview.
For that, I think there is a few solutions. I can say you have to take few, you know, demo interviews or mock interviews within amongst yourself.
You have
to select one particular topic and try to make a group and try to discuss amongst yourself so that you will get content about that particular topic as well as you will, you know, build up the confidence to, you know, how to speak, how to represent yourself in interviews and all. So that is
part and
parcel.
That will help. Yes.
Yes. Definitely. That will help.
Yes. So which qualities or skill sets do companies look for in the candidates?
Yes, of course, they are giving salary to you. So definitely they are having all rights to, see everything in his candidate. So see, I think when we were passed out at that time, scenario was very different. Like you can say 80% fundamental knowledge and 20% communication skills. You can say that was the proportion for ideal candidate. But nowadays, as scenarios are changing, I think 60% is the fundamental knowledge or basic knowledge and 40% you can say communication skills. So these are the prime two requirements for any industry. And if you are having some additional skills, then it is an add-on or you can say it's a bonus on, you know, butter on you can bread.
Yes, exactly. Sometimes the communication skills and our talk can influence our marketing.
100%. Because most of the organization nowadays, they know that you are freshers. So you are not having any idea about the industry. So what they are looking forward, how confidently you are delivering the, you know, speeches or the content, how confident you are, because they have to give some assignment to you. So they don't simply invest.
Yes, definitely.
They are trying their best to, you know, take everything out of you and you should be feel confident about whatever you are knowing, you should be tell to them. And whatever you are not knowing, you should be open enough to say, that's it. I'm not having any idea about it. Show courage over there and be transparent enough. You will definitely get selected.
Yes, okay. So according to you, what is the importance of teamwork?
Of course, teamwork is very important. You see, I think as per me, definition of team is a group of, you know, people having multiple skills. So if you see, if there are five people in a team, one person will be good in a fundamentals. One person will be good in a, you know, communication. Third person will be good in a presentation. So whenever some task will become as a team, so definitely all will contributing equally in a task and whatever product will be generated based on efforts of all of these multi-skilled people, definitely that product will be having a good quality and robust product also.
Yes.
So I think teamwork is very important, but only thing is every person should be try to, you know, give 100% of his skills. So that is only the thing and that will be taken care by team lead. I think team lead is very smart. He will take, he will assign activities also according to the skills and will ensure that this task will be get done by all of them with the equal contribution.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes. Teamwork actually contribute to the great work.
Correct.
Yes. Sir, I would like to know who is your role model in your personal life?
Personal life, you can say my father because I closely observe him. He is no more with us from last 17 years, but whatever I have learned from him, I think I am still applying those things in my maybe personal life as well as my professional life. And results are very, you know, outstanding. So that's why I will continue to do that. And yes, definitely my father.
ओके सर, ओके सर। सर, व्हाट आर योर नेक्स्ट 5 to 10 years गोल्स और वेयर डू यू होप टू बी नेक्स्ट 10 years?
Definitely, I have explained you before also, like my objective will be after, by the time I am having around 15 to 20 years of experience, I should have skills of multiple functions. Because at that time, we cannot say to the company like I am very much, you know, specialized in quality management system only, or in process validation only, or in market complaint only. Because 15 to 20 years are, it's a lots of, you know, lot of time. So definitely by the time you are having that much experience, you should have multiple skills in you. And that is my objective. So in next organization, I will again intentionally try to move from this stream to another stream so that I will get the cumulative knowledge and become a good asset for any organization. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Sir, I would like to ask a very important question to you. Like, how do you deal with the stressful situations?
See, stress is a part and parcel of your life. I think there is no one on the earth who is not having stress. Maybe a personal, professional, stress will be there with you. There is no any alternative. But I think in my case, I'm trying to find up options to, you know, negotiate that stress instead of, you know, making him or the stress dominant on me. So I think try to find out the option is a better solution for any stress. And try to come out from that stress as soon as possible, because there are lots of things we have to be, you know, do in a life, and you should not stuck at the particular stage when you will be in a stress. Try to come out from it as soon as possible. Try to find out options. Try to negotiate it, and yes, definitely you will be come out of that very fast.
Yes, sir. Sir, what are you passionate about in your life?
See, we are technical persons, and as previously explained, we are part of the noble profession. So it's nothing but, you know, this is nothing but a passion for us. Right? I am passionate about my job, about my role, whatever I'm contributing or serving to the, you know, people's community. So I'm passionate about this all things. And I'm very happy whatever I'm doing currently, and maybe in future also I will continue to do the same.
Okay, sir. Sir, I would like to know, how was your transition from your high school to your college and your college to your job now?
Okay, this is a big journey, I guess. It's very difficult to, you know, explain in a short words. But as previously explained, I have completed my school education from Marathi medium. And later on, I moved to Nasik for taking, you know, 11th and 12th science degree, you can say education. And later on, when I moved to pharma, I think I am one of those candidates, you know, who want to go to the medicals for the, or as per the family, you know, suggestion, or maybe they're like to become me as a doctor. They are finding me as a doctor. Yes. So due to that, maybe 10, 15 marks short from whatever the, you know, the target marks which were set for the admission for the medicals. So due to that, I think I went into pharma because I have not selected for doctors. And due to that, I think in first year and second year, definitely I was a bit confused because that was the thing which is always coming in my mind that, it was changed. Whatever you have decided, you were not planned, it was not work accordingly. But again, I have changed. But in first and second year, I was confused. But in third year, I think due to the guidance of faculty members, or you can say, I have taken reviews from whatever the person who are working around in a pharma. So I definitely, at that time, I thought that, yes, it's a very good profession. And we have to continue, we have to prepare for the entrance as well, so that we can, you know, pursue masters. And later on in final year, I have started working very seriously on the entrance exam. And I think results are with you. So later on, I moved to pursue my master's in Pune. And I think I have continued the same. Whatever I have learned in the final year, whatever I have prepared in final year, I have continued same momentum in master's also. And yes, definitely, I am happy whatever I have done because I am part of extracurricular activities also. So whatever the time I have, you know, transition from college to graduation and graduation to master's, it was a nice journey for me.
Yes, so there must not be any regret that you didn't get
admission. No, absolutely not. I'm not having any regret.
Because you got the right path in your further studies.
Yes. For initial 2 years, yes, it was coming in my mind that whatever what I have planned and what It is, but no, I'm not having any regret about that decision, and I'm very happy whatever I'm doing.
Yes, exactly.
I should be. I'm not having any other option else.
Okay. Yes. Sir, today we wish we could go back in the time, not to change anything, but to feel some things twice, as some of us want to go in our childhood, in our school days, in our college days. So I would like to go in our college days. We shall dive into nostalgia and release the best days of our life. And I would like to know, what was your favorite year in our college?
Favorite year, you can say final year, because that is the only year where I took this profession very seriously. And that was the turning point for, I think, my entire career. So I think final year, and same for the masters also. Okay. Again, final year, because that time only I have entered into the industry, and I think, thank God, and again, I have, you know, continued to work in the industry from there onwards. So both final years, bachelor's as well as master's.
Okay, sir. So back in the time, in the classroom, what type of student were you?
I think you can find myself in a lobby of, you know, average people, those who are not extraordinary as well as not below ordinary. So, you can say average, but I'm very happy to have that tag, average person, because I have enjoyed a lot. I have not, called as a bookish students. I have done lots of activities. You can ask Nilesh also, maybe on the field itself. But yes, I'm very happy whatever I have, you know, done in a graduation. Even though I was average, I'm more than happy enough now.
Yes, means you were the all-rounder from your college days too.
You cannot say all-rounder, but only in cricket or sports, I am having lots of interest. And I think due to that only, sports as well as studies. There is no any other activities like extra dance or any other, you know, skills. Only sports and studies. You cannot say all-rounder.
Yes. Okay. So in which co-curricular or extracurricular activities you had participated in our college? Or any achievement of yours you would like to share with us?
Okay, so in reference to previous, you know, my answer. So I was part of the, you know, team. So initially from first year itself, we have started building the cricket teams because we are having lots of interest in sports. Like me, Nilesh, Jagannath Ghare was there. We are having lot interest in a cricket. So that time also we are starting, you know, building the, hosting the tournaments in a college, and yes, in the first tournament I think we have won, and jury member was Dinesh Rishipathak sir and Parag Gede, and he selected me as a man of the series, and which I have received one book which is written by Chetan Bhagat. I think Rishipathak sir given me that book, and I think that is one of the achievement for me. And later on the next year I think we have won one more tournament, and I think that are the good achievements for me. In studies, I think don't have any achievements as I was an average student, but definitely in sports, we have that one or two those, you know, cherishing moments with us.
Okay, sir. Sir, in your cricket team, what was you? Means you were bowler, batsman, or you are all-rounder?
It depends on captain, because we used to bat as well as ball, as well as sports. Most, I think 90% people in India are all-rounders. Even though they are not very good at one particular skill, but they still are, they are saying that we are all-rounder. But yes, I can ball, I can bat, I can, you know, do everything, whatever is needed by team. And our captain was very cool, Jagannath Ghare, and it up to him what role he's assigned to me. And yes, I enjoyed batting, but...
So moving forward, I would like to take you in our practical laboratories, and I would like to know, have you done any Jugaad during practicals, and if you could tell us any of
Have you taken permission from the faculty members? Should I add those in this forum or not? But still, I will try to do it. Okay. So I think we all know that in pharmacology, I think in a second or third year, we are having one practical where we have to, you know, draw the responses, and whenever we are injecting acetylcholine and adrenaline into the, you know, solution, which is having the smooth muscles. So at that time, it's very hardly in a year, I think we are having one or two times only response, proper response. And the rest of the time, I think we are just waiting for, you know, Swati Radha ma'am to go outside the classroom, practical hall. So by that time, we are, you know, starting doing our creativity or painting skills over there. So thank God we, that practically is doing in a group of two. So my partner was Nilesh Pandey itself. So son is, you know, holding that drum. And the second person, you know, started, you know, drawing and applying his painting skills over there. So I think throughout the year, most of the time we have done that particular jugaad. And trust me, at the time of submission of those journals to the, or handing over those journals to the college, we felt really bad because whatever the creativity, that book is nothing but a journal. It's you know, full of creativities, which is done by me and Nilesh. So I think we felt very bad to hand over those journals to the college. But yes, that was one of the jugaad we have done in practicals.
Okay, sir. So which, I would like to know, which was your favorite place in our college?
You can say playground or ground, cricket ground. That was my favorite place because I, most of the time okay, I was used to, you know, over there only with my teammates and all. And if you are asking about the premises, then it will be a lobby, you can say, or the stairs.
Forward. Was there any your nickname given by your friends in college days?
I think this question should be asked to other people, other teammates, or you may be faculty members. But I could say most of the people are calling me with my surname only, Mohite, not with my name, Yogesh. So you can say it's an, okay, you know, nickname. It is not a nickname, but it's an alternative name, you can say.
I would like to ask, if you could go back in time, and which subjects lecture you would like to attend in our college again, and which faculty's lecture you would like to attend again?
I think pharmacognosy, the lecture which was used to taken by Bulbule ma'am.
Okay.
Such a nice personality. She is not with us now, but really, I would like to go again and sit in her lecture. Pharmacognosy.
Okay, sir. Sir, let's have some fun with this rapid fire round. I would like to ask some questions to you. So okay, what is the one thing that you would like to put in your bucket list?
There are lots of things I would like to add in a bucket list, but if specifically you are asking to me, then I think, you know, world tour for my family members. I really like to, you know, take them out for any destination, maybe only a particular one country, or maybe any other destination, but it should be outside India. I think that is one of the things I would like to do.
Okay, sir. So can you please describe yourself in 3 words?
It's very difficult to describe myself in 3 words, but I will add, I think I'm part of Apotex now, and in Apotex we are living 4 values. We are having our 4 values. So I will apply 3 of those to me. First one is courage. I think I'm very courageous to take tasks proactively. Second one is, you know, passion. So I'm really passionate about my job, whatever I'm doing right now. And I think third one is perseverance. So perseverance means never give up attitude. So I'm never give up to any particular task or any particular assignment that is coming to me. I'm considering that is as an opportunity for me to explore, to learn something. And I think that 3 words are more suitable to me.
Okay, sir. Sir, I would like to know, what is your lifelong dream?
Lifelong dream will be, I think I can come up with a very good person or a very good human being, as well as a technical perspective. Throughout the life, I will be, you know, be a very better technical or skillful person, so that, you know, I can contribute in a way to any pharma industry to, you know, deliver some quality and affordable medicines to the people. Maybe a life-saving one also. So I think that is one of my dreams.
Okay, sir.
To come up.
So what is your person. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
So what is your greatest achievement in your life?
I think in these 32 years, I think there are small achievements. I cannot say those are big achievements. But professionally, if you are asking me that in Dr. Reddy's, I think there was one product which was assigned to us for the, you know, completion of the review activities. It is planned to, you know, launch in a probably 1.5 months only. So for that particular project was assigned to me. So I was responsible for reviewing and completion of all the documents, clearance of all the documents which are required for that particular, you know, product launch. I can't display the name, but yes, it was a very good project, and definitely I have clear all the documents within the predefined timelines, and due to that I have got the appreciation from the site quality head as well as HR team, and I think that was one achievement which always encouraging me to do something good, and yes, that is one of the achievements.
That's great, sir. That's great. Sir, what was your first research project in our college?
In MET, I think I have done a very small project. I think it's a review of H2 receptor antagonist. Like whatever the H2 receptor antagonist brands are there in the market, I have to just took the reviews or check the reviews of all the products which are there in the market, their brand names and everything. It's just an a review article, you can say.
Okay.
But I think in masters I have done a quite good job in research, and in Met College I think that is the research project for me.
Okay, sir, your all-time favorite subject?
I think APHE is my favorite subject. I think it's in second year or first year, I don't remember. APHE, anatomy, physiology, and health education, I guess. I'm not wrong.
Okay.
Because I want to go in a medical field, so due to that, I am very easily correlate with anatomy and physiology, and that is one subject which is very favorite for me. It is throughout the 4 years, but it is, I think, only for second year it is applicable. But I really enjoy that subject.
Yes, sir. So, who was your best friend in our college?
I think all are my best friends. We cannot categorize friends, I guess. Everyone is required. But it depends on the situation and context. For example, when it comes to sports and all, I think Nilesh Pandey, Prasad Chavan, then Rahul Vadhva, then I can say Jagannath Ghare. When it comes to study, I think Mayuresh Sankar, Parag Mehta, then Vijay Vadile. Then it comes to the activities other than these two categories. Then there are lots of people like Akashdeep Dhanak. Then you can say Ketan Thorat. Multiple people are there. Srikant Patil was there. Yes.
Okay,
so
sir.
You cannot categorize the friends as the best friends or only friends. All are required, different situations.
Right. So, which was your practical batch?
I think B batch. B for brilliant.
Sir. Okay. Yes. Exactly. And who was your practical batch partner? As you told, Nilesh sir was your practical batch partner. Was he throughout 4 years, he was your practical batch partner?
Yes, almost for 80% of the practicals, he was my practical partner. And we really done very good practicals, I must say.
Okay, sir. Sir, you have to choose one.
You do not ask how and why, but we have done lots of papers over there.
Okay, sir. So choose one, organic chemistry or pharmacognosy?
I think organic chemistry. Credit goes to Dinesh Rishipathak, sir. I think he's a very brilliant faculty member. He used to come in a classroom without any, notes, without any reference, without any book, and he started drawing structures on the board. So I think that is what encouraged us to, draw at least some structures in an exam or answer papers. So I think organic chemistry.
Okay, sir. And pharmacology or pharmaceutical analysis?
Pharmaceutical analysis is a better, I guess. Again, credit goes to Sandeep Sonone, sir. Personally, I'm having very good rapport with Sandeep, sir, because he used to guide me in a lot of things, like whether I should go in after bachelor's or what project I should pick. And how to crack the entrance exam, what should be the document should be read. He given me one book also, I think Lakman was the book he gifted me during third year, I guess.
Yes.
And he was doing his PhD, I think, work at that time. So after college hour, he used to do some analysis, his own project in the practical, halls. And we used to sit with him and ask him certain questions about his project. And he always given us some rationale, some reasons, justifications. So I think due to that, the interest has been developed in pharmaceutical analysis at that time.
Okay, sir. So thank you so much for making this round so much of fun and energetic. Okay. Sir, I would like to ask you a question. Any last bits of advice that you would like to give our students?
Yes, definitely. I think first of all, you have selected a correct profession. Please do not feel bad about it. It's a very good profession, and there are lots of opportunity in the market. The only thing is, you have to improve a few things like communication skill before entering into the organization. Like already previously, I said you should be sit together as a group, try to select a topic, try to discuss on that topic so that you can get the content as well as you will be prepared for the entrance exam. And simultaneously, you will be getting those communication skills also developed within. So that is one part. Again, try to select particular skill or particular function. Like most of the people are very good in analysis, so they should have tried to go in a quality control. Most of the things are very good in a speak up or communication, then they have to go in a corporate or management. So try to select the area of interest which is more suitable for you. Try to focus on it. And I think I must say, you please do not stick to books only. You have to go on the nets also, try to learn the advanced regulatory guidelines, current updates.
Sir, last but not least, according to you, what is the best thing of our college which makes our college or our institution stand out of other institution?
Yes, definitely, because if you see, ours was the first batch which was passed out in 2010. So I think it was a foundation batch, and we are not having any seniors to guide us, just like you. But definitely at that time, whatever the faculty members are there, those are also not that much experienced, but they are young and dynamic. So I think they taught and guided us beautifully, like which college we should be preferring for, or which entrance exam we should be going for, what is the preparation plan. So everything they have guided us fantastically. And with respect to premises, that we all know that what premises we are having. I think it's one of the best premises in the University of Pune, I must say. And again, if you see the assets which are required for all the classrooms and practical, performing the practical. So everything we are having over there, even though it was the first batch or the foundation batch, but that definitely, whatever we are today, there is definitely a contribution from faculty members as well as college. So yes, definitely credit must go to the college itself. And now also I'm part of the WhatsApp group, which is created for the alumni. Placements were there, most of the interviews were held. There are institution and, corporate interactions in between. So definitely many people have been placed in most of the organization. Yes. I think that is one of the great, thing which we can, get from the MIT college. So definitely it was a different college from others with respect to premises,
yes,
with respect to opportunities, and with respect to, I think, everything. So that's it. Yes, Rahul.
Yes, sir. Exactly. Yes, sir. Our college also provides the curricular, and along with curricular, they provide the extracurricular activities too, which helps us in growing self.
Exactly. Yes, sir, definitely.
Yeah. Coming towards the conclusion of our today's episode of Jab We Met Talk series, I express my heartfelt gratitude to Mr. Yogesh Mohite, sir, for sharing his valuable experiences with us in today's episode of Jab We Met Talk show. It was my honor to host you, sir, in today's episode of Jab We Met Talk series. I am very much thankful to you, sir, for giving us your valuable time for this show. Jab We Met Talk show. It gives us deep insight in the topic and reveals some interesting facts while talking with you, sir. The point where sir told us about your career objectives and the various works from the industries was very informative. I'm pretty sure the precious knowledge that Yogesh sir had given us will definitely help us in the future and our studies as well. I hope you like our very own talk show, Jab We Met. We hope that this kindness and this support and cooperation of yours will remain with us in the future as well. Wish you favorable moments ahead. Have a great time, sir. Thank you so much. I hope our viewers also had a fun while talking this session as much as we had while talking with you, sir. Thank you so much, sir, once again. Friends, stay tuned for our next episode of Jab We Met. This is Rahul Asole signing off. Till then, take care and stay safe.